Hi, I'm Francesco Tisiot, developer advocate at Aiven. I believe if you're here, you are somehow familiar with the problems and the pains that you have to go through in order to manage yourself, your Kafka cluster, it being on premises or in the cloud of your choice. On the other side, I'm here to tell you what we at Aiven do in the backend to offer you a service which is always there when you need it and at the size that you need it. So let's go and check what's happening under the covers. First of all, let me talk to you about Aiven globally. And what I'm going to tell you now is valid for all our services, it being Kafka, InfluxDB, Grafana, M3, or Postgres, for example. Aiven is not a new company. We are offering our services since quite some time, and we have a lot of customers which are really happy with our services. What is it? Why is it so? Well, because we offer, for example, an amazing 99.99% uptime SLAs, one of the best in this cloud market. And we offer that with really predictable pricing, meaning that when you create an instance, you will see what's the amount that you will have to pay in order to maintain that instance alive. And that amount is exactly the same that you find in your bill with no surprises. The other big thing that we offer at Aiven is that the software that you will see running, the Kafka software, the Postgres software that you will see running, is exactly the same as the open source. So it means that we don't lock you in. We don't lock you in with Aiven, but we don't even lock you in with a cloud provider. Because even if you choose a specific cloud provider and region where to deploy your service, you can later on change idea and move it to another region or even cloud provider, and the whole thing will happen while the service is online. We offer those amazing platforms as managed platforms, so you can really stop worrying about keeping all the green lights up and running, but focus on what really cares to your company, the pure development. So let's talk a little bit about security. Aiven has a cert of security certification, and we are adding a few of them every year. If you want to see the updated list of certification, please go to aiven.io security compliance. Talking about security a little bit deeper, what we offer for across all our services is a list of several things, including, for example, dedicated virtual machines. So when you spin up an instance, the virtual machines will be fully dedicated to you. There will be no other clients sharing the virtual machine for you. We also offer end-to-end encryption, meaning that the data is both encrypted at rest and in transit. We offer also a complete network security and a lot of things that you can change. For example, you could reduce the IP range which can access a specific instance. And we automate both security updates and testing, minimizing all the problems that are caused to manual interventions. If you want to have more details, well, just come to aiven.io and ask a question. We'll be more than happy to reply to any of your questions. So let's talk now specifically about Apache Kafka, what we do in order to create trustable managed Apache Kafka cluster for you. The first thing that we do is regarding the minimal cluster size. Kafka is a distributed system, and you can run Kafka from a single node or a huge amount of nodes. What we do on Aiven side is we force the minimum cluster size of 3 nodes. Why do we do that? Well, because we want to ensure that your Kafka environment will be always there. So even in the case you are going to lose a specific node for any reason, you still have other 2 nodes, which makes your platform highly available and fault tolerant. When we create a Kafka cluster, we do that in the specific region of your choice, and we place our nodes knowing the topology of the region of your choice. So for example, if you choose a region with 3 availability zones, we will start including a broker in each of the availability zones available in a region. Once we used all the availability zones, if we have more brokers to assign, we will start using them. Why we do that? Well, because we want to minimize the fact that the failure of a single availability zone will take down the whole cluster. In this case, even if a wall availability zones goes down in the cloud provider of your choice, you are losing only one third of the cluster, meaning that the other two thirds are still there available to serve, all your queries. Another important factor to keep in mind when talking about Kafka is the replication factor. The replication factor dictates how many copies of a certain topic are stored across the cluster. What we do by default is to set the minimum replication factor of 2. So we are always taking at least 2 copies of a topic in our cluster. Also, this means that even if you lose a node, you're not going to lose any data. We also always check the health status of our cluster. And one of the things that we check is, for example, the disk space. We want to ensure that more or less across the cluster, there is an equal disk usage. In situations like this, where we have 2 nodes with a heavy disk usage and 1 node which has less disk usage, we do an automatic rebalancing. So we move topics from one node to the other in order to ensure that the disk usage is more or less the same. We don't do that only at topic level. We also do that, for example, if a topic has multiple partitions. What we try to avoid is that a single broker has the majority of the partition of a topic. If we find such a case, we shuffle, we rebalance the partitions across the brokers. We also try to avoid a single broker being the leader of a lot of topics. And we try to have an equal leader elections across our brokers. We do a lot of service monitoring. We, for example, ensure that all the nodes in a cluster are healthy. In cases where we found that a single node is misbehaving or is not responding well, what we do is we automatically replace it. You don't need to do anything about that. You will have always your cluster there ready for you. As I said earlier, we consistently monitor the service, the cluster, and we fix a lot of issues that are happening. But of course, you can do the same. We offer a high level of visibility of anything happening to your Kafka cluster also to you. For example, you could take the logs and the metrics coming from your Kafka cluster, and you could store them in other Aiven managed services. For example, Elasticsearch for the logs or M3 for the metrics. If you, on the other side, use external application in order to store and analyze your logs and metrics, we have a one-click integration with most of the tools available in the market. For example, you could use Amazon CloudWatch for your logs, or you could use Datadog for your metrics. And those extensions of feeding those applications with the logs coming from your Kafka cluster is just a click away or few settings away within Aiven. You can always see the list of integrations available on aiven.io/service integrations. When you talk about cloud, you cannot talk about flexibility. And in cloud, flexibility takes different shapes. One, for example, is the ability to scale up or down. For example, tomorrow I know that I will have a huge load, I want to add brokers. Or in 3 days, I want to reduce the number of nodes within my cluster because I know that the huge load will be over. We allow to do that with just one click on the web UI or one command with Aiven command line interface. And the wall new node happening or new node removing happens while the service is always online. The other part of the flexibility is even if you choose to deploy your cluster on a certain cloud in a certain region, you can later realize that you may want to switch the region or even switch the entire cloud to somewhere else. What we do is we allow that as just one click or one command as before. And what we will do in the backend is we will add the same kind of topology in a new cloud region or new cloud provider, new cloud region, and we will add the same topology. So for example, you had 3 nodes first, we add other 3 nodes, we made the 3 nodes part of the same huge cluster, which is now multi-cloud possibly, and we start transferring the topic data to the new nodes. Once the new nodes have all the content needed, we will start decommissioning the old nodes. So now your new Kafka cluster is running within the new cloud and region. The good thing is that everything is happening online with no downtime, and your endpoint doesn't change. It's completely transparent to you. You may think that we offer this kind of managed services only on core Kafka. Well, that's not true, because as I said earlier on, a lot of things also are valid for other technologies, for example, Postgres or Influx or Elasticsearch. But even staying within the Kafka world, we offer the same level of managed services also for other two components that you may find interesting. The first one being Mirrormaker 2. So with managed Mirrormaker 2, you can start replicating topics from an existing Kafka cluster inside or outside of Aiven to another Kafka cluster inside or outside of Aiven as well. So you can just focus on which topics I want to replicate and leave the management of Mirrormaker 2 private. And the same goes with Kafka Connect. Kafka Connect allows you to integrate your Kafka environment to any data source or data sync existing in your data platform. Within Aiven, we offer more than 20 managed open source connectors, meaning that you can almost integrate Kafka with any data technology available out there, always with a managed service. So all you have to do is to basically write a config file that tells when, where to source data or where to sync data. The rest is all managed. The last few words that I want to share with you are about Schema Registry and REST APIs. We offer them as well within our managed Kafka, and we offer them as part of Karapace, which is a truly open source project that was created and maintained by Aiven. And it's fully compatible with Confluent Schema Registry and REST API. So you can use the same clients, the same calls as you were using with the Confluent Schema Registry or REST API, and move to Aiven. I believe I shared with you a lot of news, a lot of information of what we do in the backend to keep your Kafka cluster secure, highly available, and always there when needed. If you have more questions, reach out to us at aiven.io or in any kind of social platform. It's everything for today. Thanks a lot for listening, and ciao from Francesco.